Assalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Praise towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and peace and blessings be upon our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Dear brothers and sisters in Islam, alhamdulillah, we are fortunate today to be in the holy month of Ramadan. Furthermore, being in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. In the nights that our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that within these nights is the night of Lailatul Qadr, the night that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed in the Quran, Lailatul Qadri khairun min alfi shahr. Lailatul Qadr is greater than 1,000 months. That means its benefits, its merits is greater than 1,000 months. Let me share with you a hadith that was narrated by Sayyidina Ali radiallahu an. He says, أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم كان يوقظ أهله في العشر الأواخر من رمضان, which means that the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم awakens his family members in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Subhanallah, dear brothers and sisters, in this short and simple hadith, we can derive from it tons and tons of lessons and benefits that we can apply in our daily lives. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam even teaches us that if a Muslim prays Isha together, that is jama'atan, faqad adraka, and that jama'ah is in the night of Lailatul Qadr, for he has already gained the merits of Lailatul Qadr. Subhanallah, dear brothers and sisters in Islam. Something so simple can be done and we can gain a lot from it. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in this hadith, he is teaching us that if you want to do this ibadah in these last 10 nights of Ramadan, we should bring together our family members to do it together with us. Wake up our wife, wake up our husbands, our children, and ask them to sit together, recite the Quran together, pray together, do zikr together. Why, brothers and sisters in Islam? Because by doing this, it will increase our love towards our family members. It will bring us together with our family members. And that is the secret that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is teaching us in our ibadah itself. From this hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and even Islam is teaching us that if we are able to gain benefit from doing something, if we are able to gain something by doing an ibadah or any other practices, we should think of others as well. We should bring others to do the same thing. We should bring others to get the benefit that we know if we do this practice, we will get it. We should not only think of ourselves, dear brothers and sisters in Islam. That is what Islam is teaching us. There is no ananiyah in Islam. There is no egoism in Islam. Therefore, may this Ramadan be the best Ramadan that we can experience in our life and our family members can join with us. Let this Ramadan be a Ramadan that teaches us to be better Muslims. And when Idul Fitr come, we become new Muslims. We become a newborn Muslim, a Muslim that gain rahmah, maghfirah, and itqu minan nar in this month of Ramadan. May we and all our family members and all our brethren be in harmony with the benefits and merits of Ramadan. Wassalamu alaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Ramadan, Ramadan, ya.